LG G3 was one of the best phones of last year. In fact, it deservedly won Trust Review's Phone of the Year award. This is its successor, the LG G4, and it comes with a few nifty new features. It's got a slightly curved screen and a fantastic camera. I've been using it for several weeks now, and today we're going to go out in London and put it through its paces. The LG G4 does look a lot like the LG G3. It's got a removable plastic back cover, but you can also get a leather cover for a little bit more money, and that is the one to go for. It feels better in your hand and it makes the phone feel a lot more premium. It's got this tiny curve to the screen as well. And for me, that's a little bit pointless. Yes, it kind of feels quite nice in your hand and it slightly comes towards your mouth while you're talking, but it's so slight that you can hardly tell. What LG does say is that this curve helps it be more robust. In other respects, the design is pretty average. It doesn't really compete with some of the metal phones out there at the moment, which just feel a lot nicer and a lot slicker to hold. These back buttons are also a great design feature. They're really easy to get to whether you're left or right-handed. What they mean is that you don't actually have any buttons ruining the sides or the top of your phone. And that's something that iPhone and a Samsung phone will have. It also means that you can get easy access to the buttons on such a large 5.5 inch screen. You know, this is the same size screen as an iPhone 6 Plus, but the phone is much, much smaller and a lot easier to handle one-handed.
It's not just the size of the screen that makes it good. The QHD resolution means it's pin sharp and colours look great on video too. It's also bright enough so you can easily see what you need to when you're outdoors on a sunny day. LG has gone for a 6-core Snapdragon 808 processor instead of the faster 810 that you find on the LG G Flex 2. Yes, it's a bit slower, but it doesn't suffer from the overheating issues we've seen in that phone. In real use, the LG G4 is more than fast enough, and the only time we experience any real slowdown is right after turning the phone on or unlocking it. Other than that, it flies. LG uses its own version of Android called Optimus. It's not quite as slick as some of the competition, but it's easy enough to use and doesn't suffer from too much bloatware. The highlight of the LG G4 is undoubtedly its camera. The 13 megapixel sensor and optical image stabilization let you take great pictures off the bat, but it also has the best manual mode of any phone on the market. This lets you do things with a phone that you've only ever been able to do with a proper camera before. For example, it lets you take shots in uncompressed RAW files, so you can keep all of the detail you want. It might not be the quickest at pointing and shooting, but if you like photography, the LG G4's camera is one of the best you can get on a phone. Aside from the awesome camera, the other major benefit of the LG G4 is the inclusion of a microSD slot and removable battery. This means you can store all of the extra music and video you want without having to fork out loads of money up front. Batteries tend to lose charge after about a year, so being able to replace one is a handy feature if you intend to keep the G4 for a while.
The G4's got a really big battery in it, but that doesn't mean that the battery life is that good. It's actually about the same as other phones in its category. It's good, but it's not fantastic.
What does this mean in real terms though? Well, it'll last you a full day, but not much more. In fact, battery life is similar to the Galaxy S6, even though that has a much smaller battery.
The LG G4 is a very good phone, but it's a little bit too similar to the G3 before it. It's got a better camera and a better screen, but the G3 is half the price, and at that sort of cost, it is really tempting. It also doesn't quite have the design cachet of something like a Samsung Galaxy S6 or HTC One M9. But on the other hand, it's got a fantastically versatile camera and one of the best screens you can get. And it manages to put this big screen in a small body. If those things are important to you, then this is one of the best phones you can go for right now.